Hi everyone, this is Ann Clemmer and Stamper from stamperdog.com. Well, it's almost time for Christmas and you've seen a lot of these before. This is that stocking die from Sizzix that we carry, and you know, it's just great. You can put the stocking this way, you can put the stocking this way. Here it is with the glimmer paper that's going away in a few days. If you do decide to do the gift card, make sure you put some sticky strip, just kind of hold this here and put the sticky strip or the multi-purpose glue right about there, or however far down you want this to go, and then that way it won't go down into the stocking any more than you want. But that's not what I'm here to show you today. What I want to show you is a different way to use this stocking that you might not have thought before, and it's for a card, and this is how we're going to do it. First off, I'm going to take a piece of 4 1/4 by 11 inch Whisper White. Now I'm going to use my scoring board to go in and fold that in half, and then off of one end I'm going to cut in 4 inches off one end, and of that 4 inches I'm going to cut just kind of like a fat inch, just maybe an inch and an eighth, not an inch and a quarter, that's a little bit too much. And so this part is 4, and this is an inch and an eighth, and put this away for some scraps to use for punching later. So now this is where it folds. And now you're going to use the scallop edge punch. And I would start on one end and work over. I'm going to take basic gray. That's what I did on the original card. I like it sometimes instead of basic black or stays on black, because it gives you the effect without being really, really dark. So I'm going to put my Dear Santa on here. Hope that's straight. If it's not, I'd do it again. But not right now. So now, on this one, I did the poinsettia, the petals of plenty, and then I went in and dotted all those with the smooch, and that's great, but this has so much texture in it that it kind of weakens the card. So instead, I've done the snowflakes, and we'll see how that goes. It seems a little bit more sturdy, so I kind of like that. Now I'm going to look in here. I'm going to take this here. What's good about this is a great card if you don't want to write a lot. I'm taking the SWAK or SWAK or SWAK or however you want to say it. It's an a la carte stamp. Doesn't cost very much. And then I'm just going to try and fill in, and I just kind of look on this where it is, and actually, you know, because I have the sample card here, I'm going to kind of go along with that and try to match this. I could go and put, you know, attach it first. That would probably be the smartest thing to do, but we've gone down this road, so that's okay. And I'm just going to, this is really a great card to give your honey, because really you just, you know, he gave you a nice card, or maybe he gave you a nice present. He gave you maybe a starter kit to become a demonstrator. I mean, who knows? Could be something really excellent. Could be some ink refills. That kind of looks like that's what I need on this. So anyway, you just kind of go along the edge of the stocking. Then I'm going to take and put some sticky strip on here, and I'm going to put the sticky strip across the top of this. I've moved my camera, so I'm hoping that I've got it in the picture. And now here I'm going to put it on the top edge of that, of the stocking, and I'm just going to put a little bit here in the middle. Actually, I could put it all the way across. I made this card quite a while ago, so you're going to see why this will work in just a second. Because it all will be clear to you in just a minute. Sometimes I make these cards a while ago, and this one I did make it a while ago, and then I start to shoot the video without thinking about it, so you know, you kind of get the reel and in the stamp room. But if you really want the real Anne in the stamp room, you've got to come and join us at themasterstamper.com, because it's actually masterstamper.com, not themasterstamper.com, because we have a live day of stamping where people stamp with me while I'm in my stamp room, and I'm in the stamp room and they're on the video. It's just really fun. So now I don't want to press that down really. I just want to press it enough to pick that up. There you go. And then with that little bit here, see, I'm just going to trim it just a little bit. 1 inch is a little bit more accurate. I could put glue on this end. It's fine. Whoa, not that much glue. Golly. I'm a glue hog here. You don't need this stuff. You really only need just a little bit. Okay, so I've got the glue, and then I've got glue here, and I think I'm just going to put a little bit of glue right across there. Just a little itty-bitty bit. That's really more reasonable. And then I'm just going to shut that down on it. And that just gives you just a little bit more of a... Here we go. Just gives you more of a finished look on the inside. Have it nice in there, and then fold this down, and then top it off with a little bit of dazzling details here around the edge when you're finally finished. That's what I did on this, and it just is enough to give it a little bit of bling. And then, but here's the thing, you notice that the toe is coming off the edge, and all I'm going to do is take my paper snips, and if you really want a really straight cut, you can take your ribbon cutting scissors, because I think these work fine with paper once in a while. I only use them once in a while on paper when I want a really straight cut and it's a long cut. I don't want it to have little snip snips like I would if I used the paper snips, but I would not use these consistently on paper. These work really well on the ribbon, and I want to keep it that way, and the fabric, they're really best suited for that. But once in a while on the cardstock, I won't tell if you won't tell. So anyway, you put a little bit of bling on here. I think that looks great, and here you go. Here's the original card. You have at it. Have a very Merry Christmas. It's okay to say Merry Christmas here. This is Anne Klemmer and Stamper from stamperdog.com. Why don't you try us out sometime and visit us at masterstamper.com and see what it's like to stamp with me real time. It can get really interesting. God bless.